We definitely know that skills that have personality are the ones that are most well-liked. So things that emulate a lot of human characteristics are what people are drawn to and become more permanent in a person's life and how they use the device. So that was an emphasis of ours, was to make sure that we had inflections in voice, we had some pausing, we might occasionally have some laughter or some jokes, but not so much that gets in the way of the person getting done what they want in the kitchen.
Geneva is my name. Controlling appliances is my game.
We took the approach of saying, you can say preheat the oven or ask for help. What would you like to do? If the user doesn't respond, we give them a moment and we re-prompt, and then we suggest all the things that they might be able to say. So we give the user the opportunity to get it right first, but then if they need a little help, we give it.
I can do presets like tea or coffee. Which do you prefer?
Inevitably in voice, we put a very large language model in there, over 40 billion things you can say. But there's going to be things the user wants to ask for in a way that's outside of that model. We're not going to understand that. And so they've already thought that they have told the device how to do the item in the most common way. And so it's much better to take ownership of not understanding that than trying to blame the user.
Apologies. You cannot change the oven configuration while it is in use.
In trying to give her personality, we kind of created a standing set of behaviors for her to act with you and not for you. So we tried to make sure all of her language was an active voice and not passive voice.
Okay, I turned off extended tumble on your dryer cycle.
That way it gives her a personality more like a human, so you feel like you're interacting more with a person and not a machine.